What's going on, guys? It's your boy Shady Mike Gaming, and welcome to today's video. Today is going to be a beginner modding tutorial. We're going to be discussing how to install mods for NBA 2K23. So if you guys like this video and like this type of content, please do like the video, subscribe for more coming from me, and consider hitting that join button and becoming a member of the Shady Mike Gaming family to support the channel further. Really appreciate all of the support on the channel as of late. So before we get into how to install mods on NBA 2K23, I do have a couple of disclaimers that I want to talk through first. First and foremost, modding NBA 2K23 can only be done on the PC version of NBA 2K23. So you can't mod PS5, can't mod PS4, any of the Xboxes, none of the consoles or anything like that. However, if you are a console player who may have been looking or thinking about making the switch to PC and was curious about how easy or how difficult this process is, this might be a good video to watch so that you can get a feel for if this is something for you. I think it's actually fairly easy. With that being said, this will be a beginner modding tutorial. I'm going to present this tutorial as if you know nothing about NBA 2K modding. However, I do expect, you know, just a limited knowledge of how to operate Windows, how to operate a PC in general. But you know, this is going to be very bare bones. We're going to stick to the basics and go through it as if we're starting from ground zero. And third and finally, in terms of my disclaimers, we are going to be modding the official version of the game, not the cracked or torrented version. It's not my place to say, you know, what's right or wrong about piracy or anything of that nature, but I did want to bring that up because if you are using the pirated version of the game and this stuff is not working, that is why. In order to do most of these things and run these programs and things of that nature, you for the most part do need the official version of the game. So with that being said, this modding tutorial is going to be broken up into a few parts. First, we're going to talk about how to set up your computer's file structure to store your mods. After that, we're going to talk about all of the modding tools that you need to mod NBA 2K23. They will be linked in the description. And then we're going to talk about where I like to go to find my mods to safely download them. And then we will talk about how to actually install mods. We're going to cover installing a Cyberface mod. We're going to talk about installing a Court and lighting mods. We're going to talk about installing globals, and we'll also go through and install a reshade. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it. So the first thing that we need to do when it comes to modding NBA 2K23, well, and this should be step one, make sure you have NBA 2K23 installed into your computer. Once you do, we need to find your root of your NBA 2K23, where that's located. So we're going to go through and we're going to show you how to find that. So first and foremost, you're going to see I have a lot of hard drives, but you're going to want to find your hard drive that has your Steam games on it. So for me, this is going to be in my Z drive. It's going to be in my F drive for me. Then I go to Steam Library, I go to Steam Apps, I go to Common, and we're going to find NBA 2K23. You can see this is a folder, it's 139 gigabytes, and once you open that, this is going to be your NBA 2K23 root. So let's go back through that. For me, it's my F drive, I go to Steam Library, I go to Steam Apps, I go to Common, and then I go to NBA 2K23. Now, the reason my structure is like that is because I have multiple drives. So if you only have one drive, yours may be fairly different. So let's go back to the basics. On this page, I used to install 2K23 on my, or excuse me, 2K on my Z drive. So we're going to open up the Z drive. We're going to go to Program Files, x86, We're then going to scroll down to Steam. We're then going to go to Steam apps. We're then going to go to common. And then you see there's 2K20 and 2K21, but you notice 2K22 and 2K23 are on different drives for me because I actually changed where I located. So your 2K folder will be in one of those locations. So let's get back to my 2K23, right? And what I want you guys to do is once you do find your 2K23 folder, what I want you to do is right click on it. And you're going to pin it to quick access. Now, once you pin it to quick access, you will notice it will be on your left. And this, once you click it, that will take you right to your root. And this is your NBA 2K root. So we're going to talk all about that and what that means for us in a little bit. But just make sure you pin that to quick access. That way we have a really easy way to get back to it. Now, after you set your root up, once you find your root, rather, I recommend making a new folder. If you don't know how to make a new folder anywhere on your desktop or in another folder, you want to right click and press new folder. And I recommend naming this folder 2K23 mods or something like that, right? I already did it, so I'm going to go ahead and delete that, right? But once I open my files back up, I'm going to click NBA 2K23. You're going to notice I have a folder here called NBA 2K23 mods. This is not going to be here for you. You have to create it. And we'll get into that in just a little bit. So make sure you create that folder. Make sure you name it something, but don't name it just mods, like M-O-D-S. Make sure you put something in front of it because we're going to get a mods folder later. So once I click into NBA 2K23 mods, you're going to notice I have a bunch of different files in here. This is how I chose to categorize all of the different types of mods out there. Ports, cyberfaces, globals, jerseys, lighting mods, miscellaneous, modding tools, reshades, and scoreboards. So I recommend making all of these different folders inside of that 2K23 folder, inside that 2K23 mods folder that you put inside your NBA 2K23 root. That way, whenever you download a mod, you can choose where you download it and you can keep all of your mods extremely organized. That way, there's no confusion or anything like that. So if you want to pause here and set those folders up, I think this is a great way to keep all of your mods stable. And, you know, organized so that you can find whatever it is that you. So next up, now that we have our file structure set up, we know how to find our 2K23 root. We know how to organize our mods. We are going to get into some of the tools that we are going to need to mod the game. Now, I have linked both of these tools in the description, but let's go ahead and take a look at the tools that we're going to be looking at. So the first tool that we're going to look at is called WinRAR. This is really simple. Click the link. It's going to take you to a page that looks like this. Download the version of WinRAR that you need. It's going to be one of these. You know, the English 64-bit is pretty much going to be what everybody needs. So download that, and then you're going to install it on your computer. I've already installed it, so I'm not going to go through that entire process. But once you install WinRAR, you are done. And we're going to talk about what WinRAR does later. But WinRAR is not something you're going to be opening up every time you get on your computer. That's one of those things that you can just install and forget about. Now that you have it, you have it. But this helps us to view mods, view modding files, and even edit them to some extent whenever we need to. So we'll keep that in the back of our minds, but just make sure you install WinRAR. That part will make a lot more sense later. After you've installed WinRAR, we're going to download something called the NBA 2K hook. This hook is what enables mods. It's made by a modder named Luya. I hope I'm saying his name right, but he's kind of the godfather of all this modding stuff. So he's, you know, made this hook for us. It helps us out a lot. I have the link in the description. It'll take you to this page. Just scroll down and hit proceed to download, and it will download for you. I've already downloaded it. So once you download that file, and I'm going to go back to my mods. I put it under modding tools. This is what it's going to look like. It's going to be a zip file. Now that we installed WinRAR, we're going to use WinRAR to open the book. All you got to do is double click it and it'll let you choose WinRAR to open that file. From now on, any type of zip file that you get is going to be automatically opened by WinRAR. So you'll see kind of like this little folder looking icon. And once you double click it, give me a sec, it will open up into this. Now, once you open up this hook file, you're going to see some files. This EYE file, ignore that, but you're going to see D input 8. You're going to see hook DLL. You're going to see a hook folder. You're going to see a mods folder. What you want to do is then go back to your 2K root file. Excuse me, your root folder, the root of 2K that we pinned to quick access is this folder right here. You're going to take this file, this file, this file, and this file. Skip the last one, but you're going to take these four and you're going to go ahead and drag them over into your 2K root. I'm not going to do that because I've already done it, but you will now have the proper mods folder, the proper files that you need in your 2K root in order to install mods. Now, once you go back over to your root, you've got your hook installed. You can see this mods folder is here. That's why we didn't want to name the folder from before 2K23 mods. I just wanted to name it something different because you're going to get this mods folder. Now, this mods folder right here is going to, and you know, don't be alarmed, I have a lot of stuff installed in here, so just ignore that. But whenever we go to install a mod, we are going to drag our files into this mods folder for the most part. Some mods are an exception and we will talk about those, but for the most part, we go to our root, we go to our mods folder, and that's how we install our. So that's the basics there of how to install the hook. You've got WinRAR as well. Now we're going to go ahead and talk about the most important thing, which is, hey, where do we get our mods? We're going to show you guys four places to get mods. And these are the places I like to get mods safely to avoid viruses. I just don't want any malicious content on my computer. I also use my computer for work and things of that nature. So we want to be as safe as possible. The first place that I go, obviously, to get mods is our 2K Modding Society Discord. I'll make sure the link is in the description. The link is in the description of all of my videos, but the 2K Modding Society Discord for me is where I get a lot of my mods. Now, when you go and join the Discord, you're going to see a section called Shady's Mods, and you can come here and download. These are going to be all the mods that I have installed in my game. So when people see my videos and want to make their game look just like mine, this is where you can go to do that. I got to update this, obviously, for 2K23, because this is all 2K22 stuff, but this will be updated in coming days. The Discord is awesome, popping community, a lot of fun conversation, things of that nature. And you can see the Discord is organized just like the file structure. So, you know, like for instance, you see a Chicago Bulls mod pack here. So, you know, the Discord, really great. Join it. You can get your mods from there. Some other options here. The website I was showing earlier, I'll go full screen here, is 2K Specialist. 2K Specialist updates a lot of times a day with a bunch of different mods that you can download and things of that nature. So 2K Specialist is a really good website. My personal favorite website is NLSC Forum. They've been around for a long time. Got a lot of great, great, great modders here. They've got threads. It's a 2K23 modding section, so you can check that out. Another website is shuagita.com. This is more like a backup website for me. This website's just not formatted very great, so I don't really love it. It's like a little bit weird to navigate, but it's still a good website to download stuff from. And then the final is EYEUC.com. This website is almost completely in Chinese. It's very hard to join, but this is where all of the other websites get their mods. This is like the original modding website. I usually have to go on Google Chrome to translate the website so I can actually navigate it. It's very hard to get an account with this site. You usually have to email them, and you know, it's hard because you got to pay to be a member, and a lot of times like they don't take our payment methods. So honestly, EYEUC is the place where most of the mods come from, but honestly it's not worth the hassle because these guys, Shuajita and 2K Specialist, have accounts there and they basically take all their mods and upload them on their own site. So I recommend just sticking to the Discord, sticking to NLSC, and sticking to 2K Specialist and just getting there. So now that we know where to get mods, now that we you know, have our game set up to receive some mods, we're gonna go through installing some mods. So the number one way that I like to go through this is just split it up by the type of mod we want to install. People are always big on Cyberfaces, so I think it's really good we can go ahead and install a Cyberface. So I'm going to go ahead and open my files again. You notice I'm in my NBA 2K23 root folder, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and open up a window here. And I downloaded an Austin Reeves. So Austin Reeves is a player for the Lakers. He's not in NBA 2K 23. He doesn't have a face scan. So I downloaded earlier an Austin Reeves mod. Now, this is really important. When you double click it, a moment to open up, it's going to open up via WinRAR and you're going to see Austin Reeves by PPP. When you open it, you're going to see .iff files. These are your modding files. Usually when you open up a Cyberface, you'll have a face file and a PNG file. Very simple. The face file edits the face, the look of and texture of the face. The PNG is the body model, for the most part. So you, when you open up Austin, the Austin Reeves one, we'll open that back up because we are going to install this one. You will notice that it's got the face file, it's got the PNG file, right? Those are the main ones. You're going to see a face and then you're going to see a number, and this one's 8087. That's the character ID, that's the player's ID. We don't need to worry about that right now. All you need to know is these .iff files are what's going to give you the actual mod. So what you want to do specifically for this Austin Reeves is you want to highlight, and then you'll go over to your mods folder in your root and simply put, just drag and drop. And now Austin Reeves is installed in A2K. So what we can do is, let me open my Steam here. We want NBA 23. We'll give that a moment to open up. So now that we're in game, we want to go ahead and take a look at our roster, and we're going to go down to Austin Reeves. And you can see, hey, he now has a Cyberface when he didn't have one before. So we've got the Austin Reeves file installed and he is now. Now I want to do something different, and let's go ahead and take a look at, for example, LeBron James. This is the basic default LeBron James. We're going to go ahead and go back to our desktop, and what I want to take a look at this LeBron James face file here. I have a LeBron James from NBA 2K22, but the thing is for NBA 2K23, the 2K22 mods don't work. The PNG files do not work in 2K23 from 2K22. However, the face files do work. So say for example you have a LeBron James that you want to use, we, in this situation we wouldn't use the PNG, but we can use face and we can drag it over into my mods folder. We're going to go back and this is our LeBron face right now, but you exit out, you can see now it looks much more realistic. He's got a little bit more of a textured face. This is a LeBron face that I've been using for a long time. You see it adds the bald spot to the back. Overall, it just gives us a much more detailed texture. But you notice I'm not using the PNG file for this. I only used the face file. Now, for the most part, as long as we download proper NBA 2K23 mods, we can use both the face and the body file, the PNG file. But for the sake of, if you ever download something and it's from 2K22 or an older game, the PNG files do not work. So that's how you install face mods. It's very easy. So next, what I want to talk about installing is some courts and lighting mods. These are our graphics mods. These are usually some of the most requested mods that we install. I've already got some installed, so I will go ahead and take us through the file structure there. What we want to do is we want to go back to our 2K23 mods. I'm actually going to look into this court right here. This is an 8K Boston Celtics court. Now, when you open the court and give that a second, you will see it's going to be an F file, F00, and then a number. All of the team's courts are numbered from 0 to like 30, you know, the NBA team. So like, but it's, I think it's like 0 to 29 because the Sixers are F000, the Bucks are F001, etc. in ABC order. So this is a Celtics court file. So this is the F005 file. I would drag this into a mods folder. I've already got it installed, so we're not going to do that right now. That's the floor of the arena. This is not the seats. This is not the lighting. This is just the floor. So any lighting mod that you use, you can still pick and choose whichever floor. Now, that's a court file. Let me go ahead and go back. Let's take a look at a lighting mod. I'm going to stick with Boston. I personally, you guys asked what lighting I use in my videos, I use Neurosos Milky Way lighting. So when I open this up, right, there's going to be three types of files in this folder. There is going to be our F files. You can see how all of these F files go all the way up this way. Again, you notice they're numbered. So each one of these stands for a different NBA team. I already have the court that I want to use. I'm not going to be using the court from Neurosos, so I'm going to be using my own F file that I downloaded separately. Then down here, you're going to see S files, and then you're going to see S light map files. Now, the S files, these are our arenas. This is the entire arena, which also encompasses your lighting mod. So this is your arena. This is your rim. This is your basket. This is the seats. This is the, you know, the lights. This is the entire arena. You then have a light map file, which determines how bright or how dark the court is and how the reflections are. So if you download a lighting mod, you want to make sure you always use all of the S files, regardless of what floor you're using, because the light map file will help bring the court along to the light and brightness that you want it to be. So for example, say I only wanted to install the Celtics lighting and light map, I would install the S005 and the S005 light map. So what I would do is I would drag all of these S files into my mods folder, and that will install the lighting and light maps for the game. I've already done it, so let's go ahead and hop in game and see what it looks like. So here we are in game. You can see the lighting is here and the official court is here as well. You notice that it now says TD Garden. We were able to successfully install both the lighting and the court. And you can see this already looks much more vibrant and much more brighter than the default NBA 2K. Now, one thing that is worth noting when it comes to the stadium lighting and court mods is that, remember, our NBA 2K22 mods do not work in NBA 2K23. But we do have a folder. It's called a shared folder that will make 2K22 and 2K21, and I believe 2K20 as well, court and stadium mods work in 2K23. So I'll make sure that's linked in the description. But when I go to it, and I want to just show it to you guys really quick, I have it under modding tools. It's called the ultimate shared folder. Second there. And all you do is you take this entire shared folder right here and drag it over into your mods folder. You can see I already have it. That's why all of my stuff works from 2K22. However, it does not affect Cyberfaces. Remember, Cyberfaces from the old games do not work in 2K20. All right, so next what I want to talk about, guys, is installing a global mod. Now, a global mod affects, well, it's named well, it affects a lot. It affects your game globally. It affects the net textures. It affects the net physics. It affects the muscles. It affects the sweat. So there's a lot. I do have a global here for 2K23. It's called KEDS Mashup Global. When you open it, give me a second, it'll come with two files, a global and a skin, right? So what you want to do is drag this into your mods folder, and it'll probably overwrite for me because I think I already had it installed. Yeah, I didn't. Okay, well, that's perfectly fine. But what you'll do is you'll notice every now and again, so like for that global, we're now done. I'm going to have better looking skin, better sweat, better, you know, textures and things of that nature. So we're done, right? But every now and again, you're going to run to a mod that says install the mod into the global. Let me open up Discord and give you guys an example. So we're going to come down and look at this mod here. It's called Xerchi's Player Edit Lighting. It changes the lighting in the player edit screen. But when you download this mod, so when I open this up, it's going to have this light rig file. And what you need to do is you need to come back over to your mods folder. You need to find your global and double click it. And so because we've already installed WinRAR, this will allow us to open up our global. And ultimately, that will let us drag this light rig file into our global. So now when I come to my edit player screen, and you notice, look at the lighting, turn my reshade off so you guys can see it, but now you can see it kind of has like that stadium lighting effect in the game. That's because I installed that file into my global. So whenever you see a download or a mod that says, hey, install this in your global, that's what they mean. That's how we do it. All right, so next we're going to talk, and last and definitely not least, because this is one of the biggest ways to impact the appearance of your game. Guys, we're going to talk about how to install, how to download and install a reshade. Now, I'm going to come back into our Discord, and I'm going to download Sam's RTGI Reshade V2. This is the reshade I've been literally using for years. This is one of my favorites. So I'm actually going to re-download that just for the sake of the video. Give that a second to finish up. I've got that now. So I'm going to save that in this folder under reshades. Now, installing reshades are a little bit different. When you open up the reshade, you're going to still open it up. And you're going to see a bunch of different files here, but these files, you are not going to drag these to your mods folder. Listen good, you're not going to drag these into the mods folder. These go directly into your 2K23 root. So I'm going to drag these into my root. We'll give that a chance to complete. Give that a second there. Replace anything that's there. And I've actually got 2K23 open, so I think I've actually got 2K23 open, so I think it'll make me close it in order to work. Okay, so now we've dragged the reshade into our root. We're going to talk about how to configure it a little bit. So I'm going to launch 2K23 with you all live so that you can see what this looks like. You'll notice some numbers and stuff will pop up at the top of your screen. That means it's working. That's perfectly okay. And we'll take a second to get in game here. I just want to go in game so that we can see what that looks like. So Sam's reshade is a little bit special because it makes you turn your anti-aliasing off in order for it to function properly. So we're going to go into freestyle. So here we are in game. And as you can see, I hope you can tell that this is looks much, much better than the default 2K, much better lighting. But what I want to do is I want to show you guys how to configure reshade. Now you're going to look on your keyboard and you're going to press the home button. Once you press home, this menu is going to pop up. You can see at the top, it's showing that we're going to be using Sam's RTGI. But what I like to do, and it'll ask you to do some things if it's your first time setting it up. So just go through the prompts. That's perfectly okay. What I like to do is to do a couple of things. So what I'm going to do is we want to go to our settings, right? And you want to make sure you set up all of these hotkeys. So you've got the overlay key. That's how you bring up this menu. Then you have F3, which is your effect toggle key. What's that mean? So if you ever want to see what the game looks like with reshade versus without it, watch what happens when I press F3. Reshade off, reshade on. Reshade off, reshade on. That's what that effect toggle key does. A cool thing that you can do as well. So you can come down here. You have a screenshot key. I have it set to print screen. And then you can set where your screenshots go. So we're going to make this our root. So I'm going to put this at F for me. I'm going to just choose my 2K23 root. And then whenever, watch this. I'm going to go here and then press the print screen button. You're going to see that text pop up at the top. Now, watch this. Stay with me. I know it's a lot of steps. We're going to go back to the root. Scroll all the way to the bottom and look at this. You've now got a perfect high quality screenshot of your game. So that right there is really cool. We're going to go back into the game now. I'm going to press home again to open this menu up. Just make sure you set your path and make sure you set the key. So for me, it's screenshot, and then I put the path to the root of the game. What I'm going to do after that is you can even use this to show your frames per second. So what I like to do is I like to click show FPS. I like to put the red to zero and the blue zero as well in the top right. Now you can see I've got an FPS counter that can show how much is the reshade affecting my performance. So you can see now I'm at like 140 frames. Turn it off. And well, my frames actually for some reason went down with the reshade off, but usually it'll go up. See, I turned it on there. Yeah, I think I'm pretty much maxed out at this point. So you can toggle and see, like you see now I'm at 130 frames, toggle it back on. Yeah, for some reason my frames are better with reshade. I don't know what that's about, but you know, you can just toggle and see how the reshade affects your game. And all right, guys, that is it for this tutorial. Thank you so much for sticking with me through that. I hope I was able to help you guys get involved with the 2K modding community. Again, if you guys, you know, ever need help, you know, comment at the end of this video, but it's much easier to join the Discord and, you know, ask your questions there. So that, you know, we can answer quickly and help you with whatever you need help with. Let me know if this was helpful and if this is going to get you guys into modding. Keep it locked to the channel. I'm going to be doing my normal modding showcases. So then you'll know what mods you want to and will be able to install once I drop those showcases. But other than that, guys, it is your boy Shady Mike Gaming. I'm signing out. Peace. Threes.